American forces were sent into Cambodia. Bravo Company helped lead the way. They were moving up a jungle trail. They entered a clearing, and that's when it happened, an ambush. Some 50 American soldiers were nearly surrounded by some 100 North Vietnamese fighters. Said Les's comrades, the enemy was everywhere, in bunkers, behind trees, up in the trees, shooting down. They opened up on them. And Les was in the rear. He could have stayed there. And those fighters were unloading on his brothers. So Les charged forward and took several of those fighters out. The enemy moved to outflank them. Les attacked and drove them back. Ammo was running low. Les ran across a clearing to grab more. An enemy grenade landed near a wounded American. Les picked it up and he threw it back. And as that grenade exploded, he shielded that soldier with his own body. And throughout history, those who have known the horror of war and the love behind all great sacrifice have tried to put those emotions into words. After the First World War, one soldier wrote this: they are more to me than life, these voices. They are more than motherliness and more than fear. They are the strongest, most comforting thing there is anywhere. They are the voices of my comrades. Those were the voices that Leslie Sabo heard that day, his comrades pinned down at risk of being overrun. And so, despite his wounds, despite the danger, Leslie did something extraordinary. He began to crawl straight toward an enemy bunker, his machine guns blazing. Those who were there said the enemy zeroed in with everything they had, but Les kept crawling, kept pulling himself along closer to that bunker, even as the bullets hit the ground all around him. And then he grabbed a grenade and he pulled the pin. It said he held that grenade and didn't throw it until the last possible moment, knowing it would take his own life, but knowing he could silence that bunker. And he did. He saved his comrades, who meant more to him than life. Leslie Sabo left behind a wife who adored him, a brother who loved him, parents who cherished him, and family and friends who admired him. But they never knew. For decades, they never knew their Les had died a hero. The fog of war and paperwork that seemed to get lost in the shuffle meant this story was almost lost to history. So today we thank that Vietnam vet who found Les's files in the archives,